Now let's move on to the demo. So this is App Connect UI on available on IBM Cloud. So if you come to App Connect, you will see several tabs available: dashboard, catalog, templates. Catalog is a page where you would see all the applications or all the connectors which are available out of the box. You can see the connectors, connectors available are in various ecosystems, be it Amazon S3 or ERP systems or SAP or any of the HR systems. So you name it, and we have all the connectors available out of the box. And also here you would see under IBM, you would see Maximo connector. And then you have something called as template. So templates are nothing but readily available integration flows. You can use templates, you can quickly get started with importing these templates and get going. Now let's move on to the demo use case that I was mentioning, where I want to build a new integration with ServiceNow and Maximo. So here you have to click on new. You can see here you're prompted with two options, either an event driven flow or an API flow. I am selecting an event driven flow here. In this case, I can name my application to suitable name. I'm saying ServiceNow to Maximo sync scenario. And once I have named my application, I am prompted with what is my event. So in this case, as I mentioned, the event which we are tracking is a new incident which is created in ServiceNow. So here you would see I am connected to various instances of ServiceNow. Like there could be several systems in a company. You can use whichever is applicable for this case. In this case, I am selecting my test ServiceNow instance, and you will see you are prompted with all the objects. I mean, all the events which can be generated in ServiceNow. I am selecting an event which is called as a new incident. So if a new incident is created on ServiceNow, do this. So do what? Now let's move on to that aspect. So once I have my event defined, now I have to write my business logic. There is a toolbox here where you will see all utilities available. For example, if you want to have a conditional logic there, or if you want to process orders in bulk and do a specific operation for each order, you can use these functionalities available there. Or if you have a use case where you want to parse an incoming data to some other format, you could use these as well. So now I know that I want to integrate this with Maximo, so I'll quickly go ahead and directly pick my Maximo connector. You'll see I'm already connected to Maximo with various accounts. If I'm not connected, I can just click on add new account, and I'll be prompted with the Maximo URL, username, password. Or if my Maximo is running on WebSphere application server, I could as well provide that. But in this case, as I'm already connected, I'll directly use the instance which I'm connected. So I'm using my Maximo test instance. Okay, once I have connected to my instance, you will see top 10 to 15 Maximo objects are displayed here. For example, companies, assets, contracts, work orders, etc., purchase orders, service order, etc. But if you click on show more, that is when we would dynamically fetch various objects available in your Dynamo and in your Maximo instance and surface them. So you'll see here the list goes on my test instance. I have these many number of objects available. So I'll be surface dynamically all these objects. I can pick any of those for my scenario. In this case, as I want to create a work order for every ServiceNow incident, I am selecting work order. I'll say create work order. And once I have selected the action which I want to do, I'll be prompted with various fields or text fields which I need to enter. Specifically, this is the mapping area where you want to map data coming from previous systems to the Maximo instance. So you will be highlighted what if there are any mandatory parameters. You would be shown those mandatory parameters without which we can't proceed further. Let me do that. Let me pick few fields from ServiceNow and populate in the work order for Maximo. So when the site is a mandatory field, so I am entering my site ID here, and then I want some description to my ticket. So I want to pick description which is coming from my ServiceNow ticket. So all I have to do is, if you click on this mapping panel, you will be shown the responses which are coming back from ServiceNow. So I will go ahead and select the description. So all it's essentially saying is, map the description, short description which is coming from ServiceNow to the Maximo work order description, right? And then I also want to assign a priority to this. So let me see where the priority field is. I mean, you can fill all these fields as per your business need, but I'm going to just fill what the bare minimum things which I would need here. Okay, and I would need a work order. So when I'm creating a work order in Maximo, I'd need a work order. So let me associate the incoming incident number itself as a work order. So what I will do is, if you have used ServiceNow, you would know that incident. I mean, it might have some prefixes. For example, in my case, it is INC. In your case, it could be something else, but I don't want that. I want a specific numerical format. So App Connect provides out of the box capabilities for a lot of transformation. So specifically, if I want to do a substring match, I am selecting substring here, and I am selecting the incoming incident number from ServiceNow, and I'll be, I know that I want to start at field 5 and I want to pick next 5 characters. So how do I know, how do I test what would be that? So I can click on this and edit the sample data to see how my string function would look like. When you click on edit sample data, you are prompted with a map panel where you can try out your sample data so that you are confident enough in your runtime that you will definitely hit those, you'll definitely achieve your end goal. So in this case, as I have mentioned, I am I'm starting the substring from 5th field and using next 5 characters. So if you see, my incident number is INC0012345. Because I am doing a substring match from fifth position, I'm just getting 12345, and this is what I would need for my work order number. So that's done now, and let me map priority. I'm picking this priority which is coming from my ServiceNow ticket. Okay, so this is done. My integration flow is done. Here you would see a prompt saying I'm ready to start my integration flow. But let me add few more documentation things, or like for my audit purpose, I'm just adding a log node so that if I want to capture something in the log around work order creation, I can do that here. And I will be prompted with Maximo work order number as well, so I can link that here. So you'll see that now my application is done and I can start my flow. I'm going ahead and starting my flow. My status changed from starting to running. And if I go to dashboard, you'll see my flow here, the one which I created just now, Snow to Maximo Sync, and you'll see the status running. Now let us test this flow. I'm going to create some new incident in ServiceNow. have created my new incident in ServiceNow, and this is my incident number INC00100049, and I have provided an urgency of 1 on like high priority. This is the short description which I have provided. So now let us see when let us move to App Connect to see how the flows are triggered. Once my flow is triggered, you will see a small tick box here which says the flow was triggered and it was run successfully. So you could then go to logs and see the last successful run. So it says my flow ran successfully, and whatever data which I have logged, I can see that there. Let us go to Maximo and see if my work order is created. So this is my Maximo instance. I am in work order. Let me search my work order. Here you go. You see the work order is created here. It is directly linked from the ServiceNow incident. So here is the description. Here is the priority which I had mapped, and it's then ready for assigning to someone else. So you could as well create an integration flow where you would do the reverse case of this. For example, like if this work order is updated with some data, you would then want to feed it back to your ServiceNow incident. You could as well do that. As I said, we support both ways of integration with Maximo. So this was a quick demo to show how you could quickly build an integration flow within 5 to 10 minutes with Maximo.